There are two main data types in Google Sheets, text and numbers. Numbers can include currency, accounting, percentage, date and time. Text can also include links and numbers as text. Finally, Google Sheets can also hold Boolean data type, which uses logic. Formatting options lets you control how your data appears in Sheets. Let's revisit our new personal budget worksheet that we have set up. Currently, it's quite basic, but with gradual modification, we can transform it into a powerful analytical tool. Let's start with our first data type, text. Text are words, such as months of the year. By default, text aligns to the left. The second largest data type are numbers, which is unsurprising considering the primary purpose of using Google Sheets and Excel is working with data. Numbers represent count of something, multiples, quantities, scores, measurement, etc. You can have negative and positive numbers and zeros as well. By default, numbers align to the right. You can also change the decimal places by clicking on either of the two icons on the format toolbar at the top. The zero with the left arrow decreases decimal places, while the double zero with the right arrow increases them. This always trips me up, as in Excel, it is opposite. By default, Google Sheets adds the thousand separated, but you can change it by going to Format, Number, Custom Number Format, and remove the thousand separator in the custom formatting box at the top. Currency is a subcategory of a number. It represents monetary values. You can start with plain numbers and then go to the dollar sign at the formatting toolbar. You can modify the decimal places depending on how much detail you want. If you need another currency than US dollar, go to Format, Number, and scroll down to the very bottom and select custom currency. Here you can search for the currency you want and adjust the currency symbol appearance before or after the number or spell it out. When you are satisfied, press the apply button. Another format that is similar to currency is the accounting format. To select it, go to Format, Number, Accounting. I actually use it more than currency, primarily because I like how the dollar sign aligns to the left of the cell. It looks much cleaner. Another difference is that zeros are indicated with a dash, so it is easier to spot them in a large data set. Finally, negative numbers are indicated with a parenthesis, which makes them a little easier to spot. You can modify the decimal places as well. The next number types are dates and time. Once you start typing a date in the cell, it recognizes it as a date and will format it that way. Another awesome trick is that once you do that, you can double click inside the cell to pull up a calendar and then select your date. If you don't like the way Google Sheets formats your dates, you can change that by going to Format, Number, and either select the default or scroll down to Custom Date and Time. The first thing here is to review the available date format and choose the one that closely resembles what you want. You will be able to semi-modify and finalize the look of it at the top. Select each part of the date formula you want to modify. For example, I can either select the month to be spelled out or abbreviated or represented by a number. You can do the same with the day and year. I consider time to be one of the most tricky numbers to deal with in Google Sheets or Excel, especially when you use it to calculate periods of time or have to use it in formulas. But formatting, it is easy. As soon as you start entering any number that represents time, Google Sheets will recognize it and will suggest a default time format. Another thing with time is that what appears in the cell is often only partial of what appears in the formula bar. In the formula bar, you really do see the formatting that is being done behind the scenes. To change the format, go to Format, Number, and either select the default or scroll down to Custom Date and Time. As with dates, you select a format closely similar to what you want, and then you can use the options at the top to customize it farther. Another number that is frequently used are percentages. With percentages, it can get tricky when you convert a number to a percentage. If you have numbers listed and you select the percentage icon on the formatting toolbar, what you will get is the multiple of the number, and most likely that's not what you want. In order for the conversion to work, you need to put the number as a decimal, because when you select to format it to percentage, it will make sense. For example, if I type 87 and then change it to percentage, it will become 8,700%, not 87% as I want. So I have to type 0.87 in order for it to become 87%. Once you have the cells formatted as percentage though, before you put in the numbers, you can just type the percentage you want and don't need to type the number as decimal, unless the percentage is a decimal. One unique text formats are links. Google Sheets GPT is smart enough to recognize you're typing a link as soon as you type .com at the end. If I just type Google, the format stays as plain text. However, as soon as I add .com to it, it becomes a link. By universal standards, links are italic, blue, and underlined. You can hover over the link to see three options. You can copy, edit, or remove the link. You can also remove links from multiple cells at once by selecting them, then scrolling all the way down to view more cell actions and selecting remove link. Finally, Google Sheets and Excel also allows for use of Boolean logic, which uses the logical operators AND, OR, AND NOT to calculate values as either true or false. For example, with Boolean logic, we can indicate if something is available, empty, approved, etc. By default, they are aligned in the center of the cell. In some circumstances, you may want to use numbers but want to treat them as text. For example, zip codes, unit codes, social security numbers, phone numbers, or credit card numbers are all examples of numbers that should be treated as text. Additionally, if you want to include zeros before your numbers, there would be another instance of treating numbers as text. By default, Google Sheets treats numbers as numerical values once they are entered. However, if you input a number in a format resembling a phone, a social security number, Google Sheets identifies it and treats it as text. You can see how Google Sheets identified the 125 and 126 here as number and aligned it to right, while the social security and phone numbers it recognized as text and aligned left. If we want to prefix our numbers with zeros, Google Sheets might not permit it initially, but by first formatting the cells as text, going to Format, Number, and selecting Plain Text, then you will have no trouble entering the zeros in front of your number. Another option to converting numbers to text is to enter an apostrophe before a number to make it plain text. Performing calculations on numbers treated as text is usually not possible. It will result in a value error. Let's recap. By default, all data that is text aligns to the left, while by default, all data that is numbers align to the right. Boolean data aligns to center. However, you can manually change the alignment of any of your data type by selecting it and clicking the horizontal alignment icon on the formatting menu. If you receive the formatted worksheet with data, it is hard to tell what data type some of the fields are. You can use the type function to test it. Type, then select the cell to test. Cells with values 1 are numbers, value 2 are text, value 4 are Boolean. After learning all of this, we can go back to our personal budget worksheet, add more data, and change all the numbers to currency, as well as fix the date formatting. Thanks so much for watching.